Good morning, people. Somewhat. Who knows?
You have 8 hours and 0 minutes of remaining drive time.
Always interrupting me. Always interrupting me. Anyways, yeah, I didn't sleep too well. Slept a couple hours and got up, checked Facebook, and come to find out one of my wife's close friends had passed away last month, and they didn't tell nobody till now. I really don't know the cause of death, but I'm suspecting in the lines of suicide, because she tried it before, but it's not confirmed. Might not ever know. But, I thought in my younger days, I fought suicide myself. Still fight depression, but I don't have the suicide problem anymore. And, turned to drinking like her. When I was a young age, became an alcoholic. Recovered from that. And, just remember, when you're making those thoughts, or making that attempt, there's always somebody there for you. No matter what you think, always remember that in the back of your mind. I think that's pretty much what saved me, because, even though me and my wife split up for 17 years, there's always that thought in the back of my head that there's that one person. There's always that one person that cares about you. So remember, if you got those thoughts in your head of doing things like that seek help immediately. Even just one little glance of the thought crosses your mind. I went through it at a young age, pretty much from 16 to 23 years old. But I don't know if that was the cause or not. No, she had a problem with it in the past, and things weren't going too well again for her. But anyways, so this video is in the memory of her. She was a sweet person. The little zebra looking blanket that you might see once in a while, Erica carrying around, was given to Erica by her. And she was a great person. Really was. Sad that it's come down to this. She was young. She's only in her 20s. We're all gonna miss her. It sucks because I know my wife's devastated, and I'm not home right now to hold her, comfort her right now. But anyways, we're gonna get out of here. We're gonna go to the yard, drop this empty off, grab another one. It might be snowing up on top. What the weather report shows. It's raining right now with wind. So let's get this party started, alright? Yeah, I didn't sleep too well, so I was gonna leave around 1 o'clock, and it's now like 2:30. I changed my alarm because I had enough time. So let's roll out of here, alright? Yeah, how to get out of here.
You tried to teach me.
If you look to your right, there's a truck over there. If you look to my left, I got a truck sticking out to one before I can't get my trailer out. We're gonna try to go left here, which I don't think is gonna work. Right? Why are you around? gotta be home, heading home tomorrow. See that truck sticking out? For fire training all weekend. So this is how they, kind of works out, because if they have a local guy that's going on vacation this week, they lose a local guy to make all the deliveries. So, or if somebody needs extra time off, one of the local drivers, and one of his OTR drivers kind of run around that's got to be home at a certain time too. The plan was to go out to Missoula, swap out with the driver and come back, which would gave me more miles by the whole getting nasty. But I get paid just as good at doing this as making a 2,000 mile run across the country. The pay and the trip numbers are different for local work. So I get the mileage and then I get some a little extra on top of that. How that works. So just like when my wife was getting close to going into labor, they were trying to keep me close. And well, we know what happened there. That didn't work. I ended up leaving my load for somebody else, which I really hate doing, but my family comes first. And I know who took my load. I thanked him and shook his hand. I said, thank you. I know which driver took my load from Spokane and onward. And I know all the drivers that helped out with that. I thanked them all. And, JB was one of them, and another guy who usually runs to New York as a team with his wife took that one out of Spokane when we left. So, that's how that works. So I'm not, you know, doing too bad. My birthday is on Saturday too, so that's another thing I want to be home for. And then we're on vacation time next month. If we can afford to go, we'll go. If not, we're not going. But I really want my daughters to meet their grandfather before, you know, my dad's up there in his late 60s, so his health ain't as good either. So I want them and girls to meet their grandfather before it's too late. So I gotta make that trip one way or another. I gotta rob Peter to pay Paul. Alright, we'll see you in Ellensburg unless we start getting snow. That wind is blowing. And we're empty. Go-go juice. I hope you got your math books all handy and ready to go and figure this one out. It's gonna be a full day today. Might get 500 miles in time I'm done doing all this. But yeah, hurry up, grab fuel, but we're not gonna hurry up because you can only fill one tank at a time here, but we're not allowed to get fuel in Oregon because of the tax. You know, everybody thinks it may be cheaper in Oregon, but it really isn't. It's actually cheaper for me to get fuel here than Oregon. Don't ask me why. I'm not the business savvy type on that end about that. Car just wanted to cross into my lines, huh? Get this thing into. But yes, we're gonna get some go-go juice. Go-go-go. Go-go-go. I don't know what this guy's doing so slowly coming out of here. Should fix your headlight before you leave, dude. Yes, we're gonna get some fuel on this end. Get some fuel and get out of here. see you soon. We're in Yakima. We're gonna get hurry up and get this done and get down the road. Take those six cases out, put them by the warehouse, and then hook on to my other drop this trailer, hook on to the other one, grab the paperwork, write my mileage down, reset my mileage, and we're leaving. Figure out where we're going in Oregon, probably Linco. Then we'll go reload our other one and then take our break and head back here sometime tomorrow. Something like that. Something like that.
Children everywhere. When you see them, I'll be there. We had joy.
help me find the sun. Every time that I was down, you would always come around and get my feet back on the ground. Goodbye, Michelle, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in seasons in the sun, the stars we could reach under starfish on a beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the stars we could reach were just starfish on a beach. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun, but the wine and the song, like the seasons, have all gone.
Turn the camera on now so you can see the view. I hope you're enjoying the view. We should make it on time. Should. Only got a couple hours of Portland, about a half an hour south of there. Maybe an hour. It should be alright. Should be alright. Yeah, I thought I'd turn it on here now so you can get the view while coming down the mountain. This tanker for hell and heavy's booking down the hill just as fast as I am. We're not heavy, we're pretty light. Burlington Northern Santa Fe Railroad. Old Northern Pacific. Down to the Columbia River. Pretty much comes out of Canada. Lake Kookanooska and all that. Would you shift? Thank you. Shift, my George! Yeah, we're gonna have to cross this river bridge again. Now you're seeing it in the daytime. Going into Oregon. Jump the interstate so we can make it on time.
Once the sun slipped down behind the mountain stream in these great cascades.
get it off the dash cam, maybe it'll pick it up. Guy's trailer came off, he's facing downhill on the road, and came off his fifth wheel and slid right into the back of the cab and halfway off the truck. There's a scale up here, then we got a little wood burn. Yeah, we went through an open scale, I didn't turn the camera on that. Way in motion. They are pretty light. Half hour early. Perfect. really gonna mess up our day. Doesn't say no turn on red, so took about 4 hours, but that's alright. Still got time to go get our other load real quick. I'm just gonna jump the interstate instead of trying to go through all the stoplights to get there. But then after we get that loaded, which hopefully won't take long, we'll go to the TA all of the day there. And then back to the yard, drop that load off, and then head home tomorrow. Oh! I don't know why bills have got to stress you out so much. Freaking power, TV, and rent still ain't caught up yet. We'll get there, eventually. Maybe. Someday. Someday. But, alright, we'll see you up at our next stop. Perfect spot too. Stevens back there. So loud on my bike. And just not sitting. Bad trick to show you guys here in a minute.
You guys, when I left out of there, I'm gonna show you neat about this truck. If somebody's talking about my phone on my lap, well, I always have my phone on my lap or sitting right on the seat beside me. That way I can see the caller ID when somebody calls, because the truck dash don't show me the name of the caller. But show you a neat system here. See? Well, let's back up. So see, my phone synced to the truck, right? That's what it does while I'm driving down the road. Yeah, that's what it does. My phone is synced into this truck. And I don't need my phone to, see. Everything synced right in, and all I gotta do is say hi Galaxy, and it does the rest. But anyways, this will be the end of today's vlog. I'm gonna go. So you all have a good night. Alright, we'll see you tonight about 1 o'clock. I'm tired. And y'all be safe. Give us Trucker Space. God bless you. And good night, my family.